Hi, Mike Mancini with PPCVideotraining.com. In this video, we're looking at our PPC or Google Ads campaign setup checklist. Now, this is something that we have just implemented in our own agency because even though we do this every single day, there are often times where we will miss a step or just, you know, we're just going so fast, we're used to just flying through it. And it's just a process that we follow. So before we launch our campaign, we know that everything is set up correctly. We know we have all the moving parts all connected together so that when we do launch, we're not gonna run into any problems or we're not missing anything. So below this video, you can go ahead and click the link in the description and you can download that spreadsheet for free. And we'll walk you through it here so we can explain exactly what each step is, and we'll try and do it quickly because some of it's pretty self-explanatory. So stick with us for just a couple minutes. By the way, if you like this, please like it or subscribe to our channel, but let's get started. All right, so this is just a PDF that we've set up and you can go ahead and print it out, save it to your computer, you can make changes to it, whatever you want. We've simplified it quite a bit because this used to have like 60 different steps. As we've gotten more experienced, we have simplified it. So obviously the first one, if the account is not set up, you have to set up your Google or Gmail account. Second, set up Google Analytics. Third, set up Google Search Console. Reason we want to do this is these all work really, really well when they are connected with each other. Number four, set up the Google Ads account. And number five, what we want to do is we want to basically connect your Google Analytics, your Google Search Console, and your Google Ads account. If you don't know how to do this, you can just link Google AdWords or Google Ads to your Google Analytics and Google Webmaster Tools or Google Search Console, which it's now been rebranded. So you'll find a million videos on how to do that. And it is really easy and quick to do. Next, you want to set up Google Ad Extensions. Make sure you're doing that because Google likes having all that extra information and they will show your ads more often than they will if you do not have those extensions. And you want your phone number on there, you want your site extensions on there. Just go through those and fill those out for whatever is applicable to your website. Now, we have tracking phone numbers that we set up for every campaign. If you have those, make sure you set those up at this point because you're gonna want those tracking phone numbers for your landing pages and for some of your ads. Next, we always go through and, you know, compile our keyword research at this time. We go through and check out our competitors. We organize and set up our keyword lists and our ad groups. And there is a keyword research or keyword spreadsheet that we use in our own agency that we've developed. I will go ahead and put the link to that video and spreadsheet below this if you want to take a look at that. And it's a free download if you want to use it. But it really helps us organize and very, very quickly set up all our keywords and our ad groups. Next, you want to go into your Google Ads account and set up your conversion tracking. Then you want to set up a thank you page on your website or your landing page provider. This is for when somebody fills out a web form. All it has to say is, thanks so much. We'll be in touch with you soon. Here is our phone number if you want to get a hold of us sooner. The reason that we set this up now is because we are going to set up a landing page and we want a thank you page to attach to it. So we need to have this set up first. After that, we're gonna add our Google Analytics tracking code to the thank you page. And then we are gonna add our conversion tracking script to the thank you page. So we know when someone has filled out that thank you page, it sets it up as a conversion in our statistics. Next, we are going to our website or our landing page provider, and we are going to set up one, I repeat, just one landing page to begin with. This is the first service or product that you want to start selling. If you have an e-commerce site, your sales page is probably already set up. We're just going to start out with that one. Why just one? Because when you set up these, if you're setting up individual landing pages, you can design and set up your entire first page, and then you can go and duplicate it and just change a few key factors. What happens here is people will start setting up, you know, they've got 10 products and they worry about setting up 10 landing pages. The reason why we do it this way, we set up one landing page, we get it up and running, we get it launched. That way we're getting traffic, hopefully getting sales, the whole time that we're setting up the other 9 products or landing pages. Now, once again, if you have an e-commerce site, obviously this goes much quicker. You can do this all right now if you'd like, but I would still suggest starting with a smaller group. Start with your best-selling products or your best-selling services, unless you have already done this before and you're a little bit more advanced and you know what's going on. If this is your own business, get up and running with a single product or service, then go back later after you launch this first one and then work on the rest. Then we want to add our Google Analytics code, the tracking code, the same one that we added to the thank you page. We're going to add it to the landing page. Then we also want to make sure at this point some landing page providers have a separate mobile optimization process. Make sure that that landing page is mobile optimized as well. Make sure that that's done right now, as that's obviously very important to search nowadays. Then we want to publish our landing page. We want to go have it go live, go check it out, make sure that it's working correctly, make sure that it looks correctly on mobile, on tablet, and on desktop. Now, here's what we can do is, depending on where you're at, if you're ready for it, go back, duplicate this landing page, and adjust it for your new services or products. So just take this one, make a copy of it, and then go through and adjust the pictures or the price or the service or whatever it might be. And now's the time to do that. Or you can also take this one and put it down at the end if you just want to get that first one up and running. Publish those new landing pages, obviously. Then you want to craft your ads. The reason you don't want to craft your ads before is because when you're crafting your ads, you will enter in the appropriate landing pages. That's why we publish those landing pages first. So go ahead and go through and craft your ads. Make sure you're using correct structure, capitalizing the words. Make sure you're using your keywords in the ads, and make sure they're very targeted. When you're crafting your ads, we have put together a Google Ads spreadsheet. It will help you craft multiple ads per ad group. It is very quick, it is very simple, and it will save you hours when setting up a campaign if you have a lot of ad groups or campaigns. This is something that we've developed in-house, something that we use literally on every single campaign. If you're interested, down below in the description, there will be a link to that with a tutorial video. And as always, it is a free download. Please, by all means, go check it out. If you use our keyword and our Google Ads spreadsheets, we show you how to upload all your Google Ads and keywords literally with a click of a mouse to AdWords Editor, all just kind of in one fell swoop. This saves you from having to go in and craft each individual ad, each individual ad group. It just saves you hours of time. So go take a look at that. But now's the time to upload your Google Ads and keywords to a Google Ads account. But make sure we're keeping those paused at this time. You don't want them up and running quite yet. Next, you want to go in and double check your ad settings. We always want to make sure that we have the correct budget set up and that we have the correct settings. Are we doing manual cost per click with enhanced checked? Are we doing return on ad spend? What settings are you using? Please make sure you double check your locations. Can't tell you how many times we'll go into audit an account where they want to only target one state, but they're targeting the entire United States and can't figure why they're going through their budget or why they're targeting the wrong people. Always make sure you go through and double check your settings at this time. This is something that sometimes you can skip over and just miss it, but here's where you're going to catch that if you have made a mistake. Go through, test your tracking phone number, give it a call, make sure it works correctly. Test your landing page form if you have not. Make sure that it's going to the right person. So make sure that when somebody fills out that form, it's not just sitting in there, that is being forwarded to the right person who can handle those and get back to those people immediately. Next, add your Google Ads coupon code if you have one. Sometimes this is, you know, spend $50 and get $100 to, you know, add it to your account, whatever it might be. If you have one of those, add it now before you launch. Then go ahead and, as nerve-wracking as it can be, launch your campaign. Go ahead and set it up. You've done everything. You've set it up correctly. You've checked your settings. You made sure that it's all working correctly. Now's the time to hit the launch button. but don't sit there and just watch over it. Go do something else. Take some time away from the computer. Otherwise, you sit there and launch it and you're going to start clicking and making sure you'll end up watching through those keywords and why aren't these getting clicked. It does take time for Google's algorithm to take and go through your campaign and start showing it. And all the ads also must be approved. So it will take a little bit. Next, over the next 7 days, keep an eye on the campaign. Maybe, you know, once or twice a day, go in there. Make sure the keywords are active. Make sure they have the correct bid so that they're showing. If the bids are not high enough, they will not show the ads. Make sure all your ads are approved and working correctly, and then adjust as needed. If you see keywords that are using up way too much of your budget, maybe you pause those right away. But don't make any huge changes to your campaign for at least a few days. Let it run, let it accrue some statistics, as scary as it might be, but be patient and just watch over it closely over the next 7 days or so and adjust as needed. All right, so that's our checklist for our Google Ads PPC campaign setup. Hopefully that helps you out a little bit. Like I said, there's the link below the video where you can download this checklist, and we hope to see you again soon. Thanks so much for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, please like or subscribe to our channel or share our video with someone else who might find it interesting. Or if you know of someone who's in need of PPC or Google Ads services, please forward our information to them. We'd love to help. Thanks so much for watching.